there, fellow movie lovers. Welcome back to Filmflash. I'm Max, and today we're diving headfirst into the thrilling world of your favorite movies. But before we get started, if you're new to the channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss a recap of your favorite films. An alien attack is occurring, and the military has explained that the creatures are impervious to bullets. However, they have one weakness. They cannot continue ascending above 8,000 feet in altitude. Therefore, the military is urging people to evacuate to higher ground above this elevation for survival. 3 years later, on a mountain in Colorado, several hundred feet below the 8,000-foot lifeline, a boy named Hunter is walking alone in the woods. He pauses for a moment, but then hears something approaching and starts running. The alien called Reapers begins chasing him, but fortunately, Hunter reaches the 8,000-foot mark, and the aliens surprisingly stop immediately. The place is called Lost Gulch Refuge, one of the communities surviving above the lifeline of 8,000 feet, with just under 200 residents living. When Hunter arrives home, his father, Will, realizes that he has gone below the lifeline elevation again and reprimands him, warning that his life is at risk every time he does so. He also emphasizes the added danger of collapsing below the lifeline, as Hunter has a lung disease that causes him to struggle to breathe. Meanwhile, a scientist named Nina works tirelessly to develop a bullet capable of piercing the Reaper's thick skin, but despite numerous attempts, she is still unsuccessful. Will notices this and recalls the time when his wife, Tara, joined Nina on an expedition to discover the Reaper's weakness, but tragically lost her life. In the middle of the night, Will wakes up to the sound of Hunter gasping for air. He immediately rushes to him and uses the last filter for Hunter's oxygen machine, helping Hunter recover. However, since they have used the last one, Will must go down the mountain soon to find medical supplies for Hunter. Will immediately visits Nina to share his plan to go down to a place called Boulder to get the medical supplies from one of the hospital, and he asks her to accompany him. Nina disagrees with the plan, arguing that it's a suicide mission and that just one Reaper could kill them both, with no chance to fight. However, Will insists that she join him, reminding her that she owes her life to Tara. Will is determined to go, as Hunter's life depends on it, and Nina, who still feels guilty about the people who died that day, has no choice but to accompany him. The next day, Will prepares and leaves the care of Hunter to one of the residents. While Will is gathering guns and ammunition, a woman named Katie arrives to join his supply run. Will disagrees, but Katie insists, claiming she is bored with her life atop the mountain and believes they will soon need to fight the Reaper anyway. Nina learns that Katie is joining the mission and warns her that she will likely be the first to die when the time comes, as she has never fought or even seen a Reaper before. However, Katie dismisses the warning. After deciding which route they will take, they leave right away. But before they descend below the 8,000-foot mark, Katie wonders why the Reapers stop exactly at 8,000 feet every time and asks Nina about it. Nina, however, despite being the best scientist in her department before, doesn't have an answer yet. After a while, they come across a military truck and search for something useful. Will finds a grenade launcher and hands it to Katie. As they continue walking toward an outpost to rest for the night, with just a few feet away from the lifeline of 8,000, a Reaper appears on Nina's radar, but it is so close that running becomes impossible. Will decides to activate the lift, but since it hasn't been used in years, he struggles to get it working. Meanwhile, Katie tries to slow down the Reaper using the grenade launcher. She fires multiple times, but the creature immediately recovers without a scratch and starts charging at them. Fortunately, Will manages to start the lift, and he and Nina begin to ride it. However, Katie gets separated and runs to the next tower, planning to jump when the lift passes beneath her. Will is able to catch her just in time, but the Reaper still follows. Nina starts shooting to slow it down, but the creature jumps and detaches the cable from the tower, causing it to derail and making them fall. However, they run and manage to reach the lifeline just before the creature can catch them, where it stops again exactly at the marking. Later, at the outpost, they drink to celebrate their survival that day and discuss how to defeat the creatures. Katie admits that she was afraid when facing the creature for the first time, but she believes they will eventually need to fight, defeat them, and take back the Earth from them. However, Nina has lost hope, having spent 3 straight years searching for the creature's weakness without finding anything. She only knows that the Reapers detect them by the carbon dioxide they exhale, but they only kill humans. On the other hand, Will is content with their life in the mountains and doesn't want to fight the creatures anymore. The next day, Will takes them to the tunnel where he had worked before. He suggests using the tunnel to reach Boulder. Both the entrance and exit of the tunnel are above 8,000 feet, but he reveals that the tunnel descends below the lifeline for 241 yards, where the creatures can see them. Nina's radar also won't work underground, making it even more dangerous as they won't be able to detect the creatures approaching. But with no other choice, they proceed. After some time, they discover that the tunnel is closed midway, and they cannot open it, forcing them to find another way. Will suggests going down now because they have no other choice. They go down, but just after a minute of walking, their fear comes true. A creature finds them, forcing them to run. They run as fast as they can, and Katie fires her last grenade launcher at the creature, making it even more fierce. They find a small room where the creature can't fit, but its tail can still reach them, so they must hold their breath to avoid releasing carbon dioxide. Will fires a flare to distract the Reaper, and they find another exit, with Katie going out first. However, the creature finds Katie and immediately kills her, dragging her away before Will can rescue her. Meanwhile, Nina finds a ladder and they immediately begin climbing it. They reach the exit, and Will and Nina mourn the loss of Katie, and Nina promises to avenge her death when she finds a way to defeat the creatures. They continue their journey and come across a truck and a house, where they rest for the night. As they eat, they once again discuss Tara's and Katie's deaths, where Nina advises Will to use his anger rather than guilt to find the strength to continue fighting. Will asks Nina why she wants to go back to her lab, and Nina reveals that she has all the supplies she needs there to create a bullet capable of penetrating the creature's skin and killing them. The next day, they prepare to descend 8,000 feet to Boulder, now using the truck. They speed to the hospital and immediately search for medical supplies for Hunter. Will believes they are located on the upper floor, so they proceed. When they reach the fifth floor, they can't find the supplies and think they might be in another room. As they search, Nina learns that a Reaper has located them. They move to another room to find the supplies, and fortunately, Will finds them. However, the creature is now inside the hospital and locates them, forcing them to run and avoid its attack. They run upstairs to escape the creature, but it follows. When they reach a room with oxygen tanks, Will devises a plan. He positions himself in a spot where he can see the Reaper coming, and when it attacks, he shoots the oxygen tanks, causing them to explode and sending the Reaper down below. When they check, the creature is not moving. They prepare to leave, but Nina pleads with Will for his help in going to her lab. She states that they cannot live like this forever and must find a way to defeat the creatures, and this is her only chance. Despite the danger, Will agrees, and they soon leave, but the creature also wakes up. They eventually reach the lab, and Nina prepares to test a bullet. They must wait a few minutes to see if it will work. As they wait, Will discovers a family photo, learning that she, too, lost all her loved ones to the creatures. Nina admits she was so focused on her job when the attack happened, that's why she wasn't with them. Nina blames herself for Tara's death, but Will tells her that neither of them are to blame, as it was Tara's decision to go with her that day. Nina tests the bullet, but it doesn't work. However, there is an unlimited supply of materials in the lab that she can use to get it right, so she decides to stay and convinces Will to leave her behind. Will momentarily disagrees, but Nina is determined, and he must choose between her and Hunter. Reluctantly, Will leaves her behind and drives away, while Nina continues to test more bullets and all fails as well. As Nina runs out of ideas, she looks at the batteries and realizes something and immediately resumes creating the bullet. Just as she finishes, a Reaper finds her, and she uses the bullet on the creature. Meanwhile, as Will drives, the truck's tire explodes, causing it to crash into a rock. Will loses consciousness, and when he wakes up, the creatures are already near him, forcing him to run toward the mountains as fast as he can, with the Reaper chasing after him. More creatures arrive, and Will is cornered on the edge of the mountain, with no hope of escape or survival. Will fires at the one positioned above him, but all the bullets are useless and won't penetrate its skin. Feeling hopeless, Will gives up, and just as the creature prepares to attack, Nina arrives from behind the creature and shoots it with her bullet, causing it to explode. She shoots the rest of the creatures, and all of them die from her bullets. Nina successfully creates a bullet for the creatures, which are revealed to be machines, not living creatures. Nina realizes this at the last moment and avoids being killed. When Will asks if she knows who created them and why, she doesn't have the answers. All she knows is that they can now fight them and defeat them in time. They start climbing back to 8,000 feet and soon reach their community. As soon as they arrive, Nina immediately raises their pirate flag, signaling to the other communities that they have found a way to defeat the creatures. Soon, they create more bullets and plan their moves for fighting the creatures, with Nina making one special bullet in honor of Katie's memories. Not long after, they prepare to hunt the Reapers and begin eliminating them one after another, marking the beginning of taking back the Earth from the invasive creatures. See you in our next film, Flash. Thank you for watching.